Two. 1, 2, 3 o'clock, 4 o'clock, rock. 5, 6, 7 o'clock, 8 o'clock, rock. 9, 10, 11 o'clock, 12 o'clock, rock. We're gonna rock around the clock tonight. Put your glad rags on. Join me home. We'll have some fun when the clock strikes one. We're gonna rock around the clock tonight. We're gonna rock, rock, rock till broad daylight. We're gonna rock around the clock tonight.
The 1950s dawned a new era for America. World War II was over, and the veterans were coming back home. The economy had made an amazing recovery since the Great Depression, and although the Cold War was prevalent, Americans were relatively secure and content at the same time. U.S. citizens were socially conservative and materialistic and held on to their Republican values while enjoying a variety of products available to them on the market, as well as the 1950s culture. Television became a part of daily life for Americans. It was used for entertainment and advertisement. Television dominated communication in the 1950s. $15.6 billion went into buying and repairing television sets throughout the 50s. The average American family watched up to 6 hours of television on average. Children's shows included the Howdy Doody Show, Lassie, Superman, and Mickey Mouse. For adults and teenagers, The Honeymooners, Leave It to Beaver, and I Love Lucy dominated. Americans across the country rushed home so they wouldn't miss the comedy hour of I Love Lucy. I Love Lucy was so popular that the number of viewers for I Love Lucy exceeded the number of viewers for Eisenhower's inauguration. Because of the popularity of television, movie theaters had a decrease in attendance. In 1952, movies became more than just movies. In the month of November, the first 3D movie was invented. At first, people were amused by this optical illusion, but the fad did not last very long at all. Movies that topped the charts in the 1950s were Singing in the Rain, 12 Angry Men, and Marilyn Monroe's Somebody Get Hot. Just
you, nobody else but you. I wanna be loved by you alone.
Children of the 1950s enjoyed their life more than any other children in American history. Children enjoyed a variety of new toys on the market. Hula hoops were a 50s favorite. When Richard Mer and Arthur Merlin released the new plastic hoop, it was an instant success. 20 million hoops were sold in the first 6 months of production. Within 2 years, over 100 million hula hoops were sold. Hula hoop popularity led to competitions and exhibitions across the country. Another toy, Mr. Potato Head, became a 50s favorite. This was the first toy in history to be advertised on television.
It's Hasbro. Hasbro makes toys. What's new, Hasbro?
Mr. and Mrs. Potato Head with their own cars and trailers. That's what's new. See, Mr. Potato Head has a car and boat trailer.
The legendary toy of the 1950s was the Barbie doll. Barbie was a fashionable, iconic doll that embodied glamour and young girls' dreams in the 50s. Other popular toys of the 1950s include Silly Putty, Matchbox Cars, Pickup Sticks, Pogo Sticks, dolls, skateboards, and jump ropes. Music was the most important part of American lifestyle in the 1950s. Adults' music consisted of romantic, bland, and sophisticated music with sleek jazz musicians such as Nat King Cole, Tony Bennett, and Peggy Lee. Record sales plummeted due to these boring tunes until 1958. When rock and roll emerged, teenagers flooded record-selling stores, purchasing over 70% of all records. The new thundering mixture of country with African-American rhythm and blues appealed to the younger Americans. The new genre was irresistible to teenage girls, who dominated the music market and turned rock and roll idols into overnight millionaires. Little Richard helped define rock and roll with his wacky dances, rebellious music, and over-the-top appearance, made him loved by many teenagers. Influential figure in rock and roll was Elvis Presley. Elvis turned rock and roll into the national teenage religion. His albums sold more than 1 million copies. His handsome looks, unique sound, and electric performances made teenagers swoon and parents shudder. His songs Blue Suede Shoes and Don't Be Cruel topped the record charts. Elvis's critics did not like his outrageous performances and sometimes required him to only be filmed from the waist up. They labeled his dance moves as wild and inappropriate.
Well, it's one for the money, two for the show, three to get ready, now go, cat, go, but don't you step on my blue suede shoe. Well, you can do anything but take me over my blue suede shoe. Well, you can knock me down, step in my face, slander my name all over the place. Well, do anything that you want to do, but not, honey, lay off them shoes. And don't you step on my blue suede shoe. Well, you can do anything but take me over my blue suede shoes. Let's go, cat! Burn my house, steal my car, drink my liquor from an old fruit jar. Well, do anything that you wanna do, but honey, lay off of my shoes. And don't you step on my blue suede shoe. Well, you can do anything but lay over my blue suede shoe.
After World War II, women left their work jobs and took their work clothes with them. Women in the 1950s dressed in a new look. Women wanted to look elegant and glamorous. Women believed it was more important to look good than be comfortable. Popular designs of the era were Christian Dior and Chanel. To top off 1950s women's new look, they wore hats, gloves, purses, and new shoes. For young women, the fashion rage was the poodle skirt. Every girl wanted one and had to have one. They were bright colors and worn with contrasting sweaters and scarves. The new fashion was an iconic symbol for beauty and a hopeful future. Men's fashion didn't change very much in the 1950s. Men always wore hats and wore a teddy boy style suit. The teddy boy was a suit with a long jacket. Other young men wore nonconformist clothing, the clothing as seen in Grease and A Rebel Without a Cause. Denim jeans, a white t-shirt, and a leather jacket became the symbol of rebellion. The most famous hairstyle for boys in the 50s was the ducktail hairstyle with long sideburns. Enormous amounts of hair grease was needed to accomplish this look. A new wave of American-bred bohemians emerged, calling themselves the Beat Generation. The Beatniks originated in the west coast of San Francisco. Beats felt that they had been blessed with mystical powers, But many of the Bohemians fought in the Korean War and were disillusioned with the old American dream of prosperity and conformity. For them, beat just meant beaten down. They spoke with words from the Negro jazz artist. They experimented with marijuana and called it pot. Their houses were scarcely furnished, with only a mattress, guitar, records, and books. The beatniks were not appreciated by the media. The stereotype was that they lived lazy, unproductive lives and rebelled against social norms. Although the stereotype exists, Jack Kerouac, an influential beat, said, "We love everything. Billy Graham, the Big Ten, rock and roll, Zen, apple pie, Eisenhower. We dig it all." With Americans attached to their black and white televisions, the TV dinner was born. Americans could watch their favorite television shows and eat dinner at the same time. Americans watched the I Love Lucy comedy hour while eating dinner that was easily cooked in a few minutes. Another major improvement in food was the Speedy system. The Speedy system was a forerunner to the fast food system we use today. McDonald's launched their Speedy system with the invention of the speaker system. Cars came and went as the popularity of fast food soared.
McDonald's hamburgers is music to our ears.
Fast food restaurants sold hamburgers, hot dogs, french fries, and ice cream. Denny's restaurants opened up around the country and became the U.S.'s first service family restaurant chain. Many critics of '50s looked on the audience as victims of some kind of cultural conspiracy. For instance, comic books corrupted the young, rock and roll encouraged rebellion, and television dulled the mind. There was some truth in these assertions, but there was no conspiracy. Mass culture gave mass audiences what they wanted. Nothing was forced on the public. The consumer could always switch the dial, refuse to buy the record, or stay home from the film. The audience had the power, and the culture that resulted was far more diverse than most 1950s stereotypes admit. In essence, the 1950s dominated popular culture from Disney to fashion to children's stories to mind-consuming television programs and music. Although the culture can be overshadowed by other events during the era, it helped lay the groundwork for the 1960s.
Walking through a party in the county jail, the prison band was there, they began to wail. The band was jumping and the joint began to swing. You should have heard your knocked out jailbird sing. Let it rock, everybody, let it rock. Everybody in the wholesale block was dancing to the jail out rock. Spider Murphy played it in a saxophone. Little Joe was blowing on the slide trombone. The drummer for the Miller, the crash boom bang. The whole rhythm section was a perfect.